I recently switched to a network attached storage drive from Synology. I made a video all about it, as you might have seen, and maybe that's why you're watching this video as well. But one of the questions I had when I got into it is, how would it deal with things like multicam editing? How would it work having network-based storage wirelessly to my computer to be able to edit multicams, 3-4 cameras at once in 4K, 1080, all those things? Would I have issues when it comes to anything other than the standard editing? And so I wanted to show you just proof of how good it actually works for us and let you see just how simple it is. As you can see, I am 100% wireless right now. So this is just proving to you that footage I'm about to show you that I'm working off of is not plugged into this computer. I'm also going to show you on my desktop that those are not on there as well. The Synology drive is right in the corner over there behind the camera, and it is hooked up to my network, and I'm wirelessly connecting to it. That's actually how we always connect to it. You can directly plug in an Ethernet right to the unit itself and edit off of that way, but all of us here at my home studio and all my editors remotely all connect to the Synology just wirelessly, so they can be anywhere in their house, and we really like that. Most likely, it probably is slower than if you actually were to connect to it directly, but we've noticed no sort of lag issues or anything that slows us down from doing the editing we normally do, and that's what I wanted to show you. So here we are on the desktop, and as you can see, I will go to go, connect to server, and I will connect to the Synology server, and here it is. For this example, I'm going to use the Freedom Equation podcast that I have, because that is something that we do with multiple cameras and multiple audio sources, and so that's a good example of just an everyday multicam production. So as you can see, I'm connected here to it, all wirelessly, and if I go ahead and open up one of the Final Cut libraries from that Freedom Equation podcast. While this is opening, this is a 16-inch MacBook Pro M1 Max. It's spec'd out to the max. So if you wanted to know any of the computer specs, that is the information you need right there. You can see here, this is the whole entire library. So as you can see, there's a bunch of projects in here. So it looks like I have 25 projects in here, and there's content, there's different things. So here's an example here of an episode. And as you see in this episode, this is a multicam production. So as you see, here are the different cameras. There are three cameras. We got 4K, two of them are 4K, I believe, and one is 1080. And then there are multiple audio sources. So if I go into this multicam production here, you can see the three camera angles. And actually, this is just the full edited audio from the podcast, since we already edited the audio. And you can see here in real time that if I let this play, you will see how there is no buffering and it works just like you'd expect.
In the first place.
Yeah.
And I've just seen a lot of people that struggle with it, not necessarily from the ego of like, I can't let go of things, but I just don't like having to pay attention to what.
And you can see here, if I change my angles just like I normally would. Let's change that to only change the video, not the audio. That way you don't have to hear the change in audio. So if I play this and I change my clips,
all the things I do repeated, I just have camera one, but I've never necessarily written it down as a system for somebody else to follow. And so it took me so much time to train her. And she was a student, so she ended up leaving me like a couple months later. And I just remember thinking to myself, oh my God.
So you can see no problem. And even if I actually double time the episode, which a lot of times when I'm listening to something like this that is, 15 minutes, 20 minutes long or whatever, I will double time the speed when I'm watching it in Final Cut. And even in multicam view, when I do that,
what a waste of time. And I don't want to do this again. But for a really long time too, like, she would do things and I would just sort of cringe inside.
So you can hear how the audio still works perfect. Obviously, there's a little bit, tiny
because
bit of buffering.
Isn't exactly what, how I would have done it.
Yeah.
But
that's
one,
just it catching
I
up. So when I'm just doing my normal multicam edits, though,
SOPs,
no sort of problem whatsoever.
And I feel like you're pretty good at that, developing.
I try, yeah.
Okay. And you can see just like normal, if I want to go in and adjust color or adjust anything on any of the individual clips, obviously I have no issue doing that. I can process this just as fast as I normally would. No sort of delay slowing me down. Still tweak anything how I want. And I can work on it just like I want. I can scrub around and it works just like I'd expect. And as you can see, just in case you are still doubting me, this is right here. It's showing that it's on the Scaling Creative main office drive. So it is not coming from my computer directly. It's on the main office drive. One thing you can also note in this is the fact that this stuff is not even rendered yet. So as you can see from all the dotted line above the bar, none of this is even rendered. So we're watching it just unrendered with no problem at all. There is a LUT over top of this as well. So as you see in this main thing here, there's a LUT over top of all the footage as well as color correction on the footage directly inside of this. So we're using a LUT. We're doing all that stuff like we normally would. We're doing no sort of limited, you know, versions of this edit just because it's remote and wirelessly connected here. So all that works, no problem at all. If I go to another episode, just so you can see another episode doing this, let's just go to episode 7. Here we are again, another multicam. I can go ahead and just let this play.
Destination. Like, I want to arrive. I want to, even if it's, I want to be married. I just want to be married. Everything's going to be better if I'm married. Everything's going to be better if I hit 100K. Everything's going to be better if I, you know, scale to this, scale to that. And when you're so obsessed with the outcome.
Okay. So no problems whatsoever. And I think that was a thing that I didn't really find a lot of information for online is how good would that actually work. And to my surprise, it works really, really well. I was kind of thinking, honestly, that when we went to this type of system that we were going to have to probably not be able to do everything exactly how we normally would because of that, you know, server-based editing when we're all editing on the same time. But even right at the second, I'm editing off of the server. Ben is editing off the server on a project, and Allison is also editing off of the server remotely. So it's not like this is just a, you know, random time that everything is just working perfect and I'm the only one on the server. So, and a lot of you were surprised in the last video the fact that we connect to our server like wirelessly. A lot of times when you're in a home environment or even if you're working on a network attached storage, you actually still will run an Ethernet to it so that you're hardwired into that system, but we just haven't done that and it's given us no issues. And I think that's even better because I can actually take my laptop upstairs if I want and work, you know, if I'm watching my kids later in the afternoon or something, I can still work off the server and still edit things, and it's pretty awesome. So yeah, just wanted to show you a quick example of just how effective it actually is for us and hopefully answer the question that I didn't feel like there were a lot of answers to online. You can multicam with a NAS, no problem. So far, it's been awesome for us. Hope this helps. Let me know what other questions you might have.